I wish that amazing tools like this were available when I was getting started, let alone free. If you have seen any videos on this channel, you know how much I like motion VFX plugins for Final Cut Pro. Well, they just doubled down on the future of DaVinci Resolve. Motion VFX has started offering plugins for DaVinci, and their first Resolve plugin is for free. Things are about to get super interesting, and in this video, let's take a look at this plugin and see where motion VFX is heading. I'm Rafael, and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post. And I always appreciate the early thumbs up because there isn't a better time to get started as a creator. Both DaVinci and this plugin pack are free. You could literally start a YouTube channel today and have all the editing tools you'd need. I don't think I can stress how big of a deal this is. There's almost no barrier to entry if you have a smartphone and access to a computer. You now have all the tools you need to start creating. I personally love using Final Cut Pro because of its ease of use, and I find that it's the fastest in and out non-linear editor for a crew of one, but it does cost $300 US, whereas Resolve has the power of cross-platform accessibility and it is free, which is unmatched in any other software. And one of the biggest challenges for many creators is adding those final touches to their videos, specifically graphics, the callouts, the lower thirds, the titles, anything that enhances the visual appeal. Creating from scratch is really hard. It's a specific skill that can take years to hone, where Motion VFX for years has made their plugins for Final Cut Pro to help with the creation of these graphics, but still give you enough flexibility to change them to match the look and feel that you're after. The colors, fonts, logos, and other images. Those are all things that you can change. I call these dynamic templates. And with this YouTube channel, I have relied on them from the start. Even though I do this professionally, I still use them for my channel because I know how long it takes to create a broadcast package for a show. And I want to get up and running as fast as possible with a look and feel that was still me, but without having to create it from scratch. And this is one of the biggest reasons I didn't switch over to DaVinci for my YouTube videos. I use DaVinci a lot for my client work, but for the YouTube channel, I have to be as fast and efficient as possible to get these in and out without taking up too much time from my everyday work. And I am always looking for better and faster ways to do the things that still achieve the quality results I expect. If I was starting today with no software and a limited budget, it would be a no-brainer to download DaVinci and start with the Motion VFX plugins. But if you have Final Cut Pro already, there isn't anything much better in my opinion. But for free, DaVinci is the king of NLEs, and it's a powerhouse of features. And Blackmagic continually improves it year over year. I actually don't think that there's a company that is pushing their software as fast as Blackmagic. Let's take a look at what Motion VFX is now offering for DaVinci. MHelloDV, it's a pack of useful pre-animated editable assets you can use in your DaVinci projects. You have magnifying glass, you have transitions, retro frame, glass effect, you have an intro for your logo, you have titles and backgrounds, lower thirds, avatar, and it's all for free. It's easy to install and use, and if you know the basics of DaVinci, you'll feel right at home with this plugin. If you're not familiar with DaVinci, Blackmagic has hours of free tutorials on this site, so make sure you check those out. MHelloDV is a small taste of what Motion VFX is bringing. They've already updated a few of their plugins like MTuber, which is a great package if you're creating just for YouTube, with all the titles and graphics you would need to get a great YouTube channel started and off the ground really fast. And Motion VFX has committed to updating all their plugins and templates to be Final Cut Pro and DaVinci. Though a thing I would love to see in the future, if possible, is a translation tool. So all the modifications that I did in Final Cut, I would be able to export them into DaVinci. Because honestly, I don't look forward to recreating all these elements just to start using DaVinci, because there are so many assets. This is not a sponsored video, even though it does sound like it because I'm gushing. I just love their plugins and how much time they've saved me over the past 2 years creating for this YouTube channel. I know why Motion VFX decided to bring their offerings to DaVinci. It opens up a whole other world of creators that are only on PC and that don't use Macs or Final Cut Pro. And the accessibility of DaVinci Resolve is such a great opportunity for them to grow their business and reach, including those markets. But the question does remain, why not include more Premiere Pro offerings? Well, I have a whole video on why I feel Premiere Pro is dead. They just don't know it yet. Make sure you check that out. Also, I live stream on my second channel where I deep dive into the creative process as well as freelance financials. So make sure you check that out. As always, thanks for watching.